ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದೇಶ್ವರ ಸಮಾರಂಭಾಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದೇಶ್ವರಿ ಮಧ್ಯಮಾಂ ಅಸ್ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಪರ್ಯಂತಾಂ ವಂದೇ ಗುರು ಪರಂಪರಾಂ. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, Sarvangyapita Yajamans, Nitya Satsangis, Srimahans, Mahans, Kotaris, Tanedars, visitors and YouTube subscribers and viewers all over the world. Sitting with us through Nityananda TV, Facebook Live, YouTube Live and two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Diksha. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today, India is celebrating her 70th year of independence. Let Bharat Mata be the Jagat Guru. I pray to Sadashiva, let him manifest himself, bless himself, bless this country such a way, let Bharat Mata be the Jagat Guru. Let me enter into today's satsang. The Kenopanishad, 6th verse. Please recite along with me. Yan manasa ನಮನುತೆ ಯೇನಾಹುರ್ಮನೋಮತಂ ತತೇವ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮತ್ವಂ ವಿದ್ಯಿನೇತಂ ಯದಿ ತಮುಪಾಸತೆ. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದ 7, 8, ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. So I'll recite all these next verses and then reveal the sacred secrets from all the next verses also. Recite along with me. Yat chakshusha na pashyati ena chakshumshi pashyati tateva brahmatvam ವಿದ್ಯಿ ನೇತಂ ಯತಿ ತಮುಪಾಸತೆ ಯಶ್ರೋತ್ರೇಣ ನ ಶೃಣೋತಿ ಏನ ಶ್ರೋತ್ರಮಿದಂ ಶ್ರುತಂ ತದೇವ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮತ್ವಂ ವಿದ್ಯಿನೇತಂ ಯತಿ ತಮುಪಾಸತೆ. ಯತ್ ಪ್ರಾಣೇನ ನ ಪ್ರಾಣೀತಿ ಏನ ಪ್ರಾಣ ಪ್ರಣೀಯತೆ ತತೇವ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮತ್ವಂ ವಿದ್ಯಿ ನೇತಂ ಯತಿ ತಮುಪಾಸತೆ. ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ 4th ವರ್ಸ್ ಟು 9th ವರ್ಸ್, ಬ್ರಹ್ಮತ್ವಂ ವಿದ್ಯಿ ಏನಂ ನೇತಂ ಯತಿ ತಮುಪಾಸತೆ. ಲಿಸನ್, ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಲೈನ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್. ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ 100% ಶ್ಯೂರ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ 108 ಉಪನಿಷತ್ಸ್, this is the one line most repeated. No line gets repeated 5 times. Brahmatvam vidyinetam yatitamupasate. Netam yatitamupasate. Let me enter into the 7th verse. Listen. The verse, the translation of the verse is, that which is not seen by the eye, but because of which the eye, the organ of sight, is able to see and perceive the seen, you must know that reality alone as Brahman, and not this which is worshipped and cherished here as this finite, limited object. Understand, even the most beautiful expression, don't be diverted by what it is trying to instigate in you, but be concentrated on from where you perceive this. Understand? Sadashiva explains about beauty in Agama. In one place, very beautifully expressed. Who is beautiful person? Many places Sadashiva does not use the gender, beautiful man or beautiful woman, no. Because we believe in 11 genders, he just says beautiful being. 3 qualifications he gives. The moment you see, you should be stunning. The eye should just pop up. Automatically the eye should expand. That's the first. Listen carefully. The moment you see, eye should just pop up. That's stunning. Second, the grace should flow in every action. From the moment of waking up to the moment of falling asleep, grace should permeate in every action and every bhavana that person, the third point, every bhavana that person assumes. If you have to define, translate in a modern way, the every dress he wears or every attitude he assumes, every aspiration he assumes, every bhavana, visualization, he assumes it should radiate beauty. These are the 3 qualifications he gives for a beautiful being. First, the moment you see, stunning, eyes should pop up. Next, whole action, sitting, standing, dancing, eating, sleeping, everything should permeate that beauty, grace. Third, every attitude he assumes, means whether he wears jewels or dresses up or no jewels or any aspect, anything should fit. Even if these 3 qualities are expressed, don't be diverted by what is expressed. Look in who is expressing. Understand. Don't be diverted by what is expressed. Look in who is expressing. When you look in who is expressing, you become Jivan Mukta. Look in. Who can express this? Look in. Who is expressing this? Even the most beautiful things, sun and the moon and the nature and the ocean, the hill, amazing, beautiful beings, powers, best visualizations, extreme beauty of flowing Ganga, extraordinary beauty of standing Himalayas. Whatever, whatever, whatever. All these visualizations, all these forms, don't be diverted by what is shown, but see who is showing. Understand? The world, my world. For example, you see a mountain. Mountain is the world, and that peace or a mood it creates in you is my world. Whether in the world or my world, don't be distracted by what is seen and perceived. See who is perceiving in the my world. You will achieve the Atman. You will achieve the super consciousness. See who is showing all this. You will achieve the Sadashivatva. Whether in the world you see who is showing this, or my world you see who is perceiving this, you will achieve Sadashivatva. You will achieve the ultimate. You will achieve the Shivoham Anubhuti. You will achieve the Atmanjnana. You will achieve the Brahmanjnana. You will achieve the ultimate enlightenment. In both, enjoy both. Don't be distracted by it. Enjoy powerfully, but know it. The source is what matters, not the experience. Source is what matters, not the superficial. Source matters, not the superficial. Always put your attention on the source. If you are putting your attention on superficial, both your eyes will enjoy. If you are putting the attention on the source, your third eye will enjoy. Your third eye will be awakened. That will enjoy. External or internal, let your third eye enjoy always. Understand? Still I have not seen any modern day beautician or the people who work on these beauty industries explain beauty in such a precise way like Sadashiva. What a definition. After defining, he says, look at the source who is showing. Because that is too beautiful, which cannot be described. If the expression itself is this beautiful, then how the experience will be? If the statement can be so poetic, how the state will be poetry? What kind of a poetry the state will be? If the statement can be so poetry, such poetry, how poetic the state will be? Or if the statement can be so poetic, what level of poetry will be the state? So let all the glory, visualization, beauty you see in the world or my world remind you to the source. Remind you to the source. Remind you to the source. Viddhi netam yatitam upasate. Viddhi netam yatitam upasate. Listen, listen. Yachakshusha napashyati ena chakshumshi pashyati means not which is seen by the eye, but because of which the eye, the organ of sight, is able to see and perceive the seen. That is reality. Understand? Not which is seen by the eyes, but by which the eyes are able to see and perceive. Not which is seen by the eyes, but because of which the eyes are able to see and perceive. Listen, this has to get drilled into you. Not by which is seen by the eyes, but because of which the eyes are able to see and perceive. That which is seen by the eye, understand, that which is seen by the eye, not because of that, but because of which the eyes are able to see. The eyes are able to see, but because of which the eyes are able to see. Yat chakshusha na pasyati ena chakshumshi pasyati tateva brahmatvam vidhinetam yaditam upasate. Go on contemplating. I want to repeat. How much ever beautiful, graceful the seen is, the handsome, the being is, I tell you, look at the source, you will reach the space and taste and experience much deeper, sweeter, beautiful than what is expressed. Any enjoyment of expression will bring boredom at one point. Only if you look at the source, you will make boredom and tiredness redundant in your life. The source from where these expressions happen, the source from which your eyes perceive. Look at the source. Let your attention be on that source. Let your attention be on that source. Yat chakshusha na pasyati ena chakshumshi pasyati tateva brahmatvam viddhi netam yatitam upasate. Yat chakshusha na pasyati ena chakshumshi pasyati tadeva brahmatvam viddhi netam yatitam upasate. I'm blown away by the authenticity of the Upanishad. What a sacrifice. It says, anybody who can express, always try to make people slave through their expression. That's what the actors do. They want people to become their slaves just because of the way they look, the way they carry themselves gracefully, the way they portray themselves. See here, the authenticity of the Upanishads. I know for sure the Upanishadic rishis have looked more handsome than any superstars, because they are real stars. The Sabda Rishis are the real stars. But with all their beauty, grace, handsomeness, they remind you to look at the source which is expressing, not the scene which is perceived. Because the scene which is perceived will bring tiredness and boredom after some time. But if you turn towards the source, that is the most extraordinary, eternal experience of beauty, bliss, joy, consciousness, all the best things. All the best things. Understand. Understand. What is seen? What is seen? What is perceived? If you can see, start putting your attention to the source. Actually, I tell you, even in your day-to-day life, if you start going towards the source, you will have a very stable family, stable relationship. Whenever you run around based on what is seen, you will have such an unstable relationships, because anything will be stunning if it is new for some days. But nothing will be graceful from morning till night once you start living with it, other than an enlightened being. Understand? So in your ordinary life, even there, if you start seeing what is seen, what is it that is behind what is seen, even your life will become stable. Your life will become stable. Today's subject for Vakyartha Sadas: seen are the source of the seer. Seer who sees the source becomes seer. Seer who is all the time in seen becomes seen object. The Vakyartha Sadas subject is seen or the seer. The Facebook status for all of you is not by the seen, but by the source of the seer. I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhadvaita Saivam, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.